there are these butterflies in Central America. They're blue and orange and yellow, and they have poison in their wings. Just enough poison to stop a bird heart. But the birds know this somehow, so they don't eat them. But there are other ones, butterflies. They're orange, blue, and yellow too, but no poison wings. They're just flying around looking dangerous, getting by on their looks. Toro, that's what the Spanish bullfighters say. But it's also what the Japanese call the high-end tuna sushi, Toro. Raw fish. Who went first on that one? The guy without the grill. I've been to Tokyo. They sell little girl underwear in the vending machines right on the main drag, the Ginza, or whatever. Guys in suits buying used girl panties. How is that okay? That's not okay. There's a sale at Bacharach's. They have those Oscar de la Renta ties that nobody buys. What are they, two for one for another week? Diagonal bands of color hanging around your neck. They never put the nice Brioni ties on sale. I should just get all my ties in Paris, wear them once or twice and shove them in a duty-free bag. Nobody gets stopped at customs for ties. You think the automobile companies can't make a car tomorrow that gets 100 miles to the gallon? You think the TV networks don't know who's going to win the World Series before the season starts? Paranoid is what people who are trying to take advantage call you in an effort to get you to drop your guard. I read that the other day in an in-flight magazine. I don't like wool on skin. Not even that merino wool they have at Marshall Field in Chicago. Ginger likes it because it's form-fitting, but she likes avocados, and who wants that texture in their mouth? Who would make up someone named Regina? It's the capital of Saskatchewan. I like my hands. I think they're probably my favorite part of my body. I think that can be used to my advantage in social situations. If I can get people focused on my hands, then I can get a good result in the meeting. Eye contact is real important, too. Being able to do two things at once is a big part of success. I try and do abdominal exercises, isometrics, even when I'm at a meeting. Tensing, holding, and then releasing. I'll even floss in the shower while the conditioner is in my hair, during the part when you're just supposed to leave it in. Those things can really add up to a significant time savings.
Hey, Kirk.
The metric system never panned out. We all had rulers with inches on one edge and centimeters on the other. I pronounced it centimiters instead of centimeters, and nobody ever corrected me. They just let me walk around stupid, so I'm not really upset we never crossed over, although it's helpful to know the conversions when I go to Europe. The liter bottle is the only thing that ever caught on, because it's a nicer word, liter, than quart. 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 One of the Japanese guys told me a story. This lysine salesman is in a meeting with someone from Conagra or some other company, I don't know, and the client leans forward and says, "I have the same tie as you, only the pattern is reversed." And then he drops dead, face down on the table, alive and then dead, brain aneurysm. Maybe everyone has a sentence like that, a little time bomb. "I have the same tie as you, only the pattern's reversed, dead." The last thing they'll ever say. Something like,
"High fructose corn syrup." There it is again.
Oh, it went great. I think we're gonna be able to keep it at a buck and a quarter.
Now what happens? Something you breathe in on an airplane. Some little bacteria, and now it's in his hands, the cup, the phone. Probably got it from his kids, and now I'll spend the weekend with it in bed. And I'll miss a few days next week, or Alexander will run a fever, and who pays for that? Where does the FBI weigh in on that as a cooperating witness? What does it say about exposure to airborne contaminants?